Hello everyone, welcome to the TSS. In this class we are going to discuss about how to use Bootstrap framework and where to get that Bootstrap file. Okay, so there are two ways to start using Bootstrap on your own website, friends. That is, first one is you can download the source code, that means styles which are predefined CSS styles file from getbootstrap.com, this website. That is the one method. And after downloading that predefined CSS styles, you need to link that CSS file to your web page in the head section with the link tag. Okay, so that is one way. And the other way is you can include Bootstrap from the CDN. CDN means content delivery network. Some content delivery networks host this file. Okay, so in that case you can directly give the web address of the content delivery network on which the CSS file exists. Okay, so in these two ways you can use. Both ways requires two document to look for CSS styles outside the web page. Okay, so whether it may be, you can download it from bootstrap.com and then you need to link that downloaded CSS styles in your generally you put that downloaded file in your root directory of your web server. So you need to mention the path of the downloaded CSS file with the link tags at the head section. And in the same in case of CDN also, you can mention the path. This time it is not the local path of the file. In case of CDN, it is the web address of that CSS file. So this is the example. So it is the format of inserting, linking the Bootstrap styles to your web page. So we already discussed this. A link tag is used to link the external style sheet to your web page. So link, rel, relation, this is style sheet. This is the path, hyper reference. This is the path, that is HTTP. This is which path, this is not the local path. This is the CDN path, that is maccdn.bootstrapcdn.com/bootstrap/3.4.0. 3.4.0 is the version number, and CSS, in that CSS this is the file name, and these are all the folders. Okay, bootstrap.min.css. min means minified. Minified means the lines are continuous lines will be there. It is not in proper format, but it will load fastly. Okay, and then jQuery library is also there, so you can link the jQuery and JavaScript. If you want to link the JavaScript files, then you can make use of script tag and source as a path, right? Path to the JavaScript file. It is also CDN path only. Okay, jQuery, it is an amazing JavaScript library, okay, for applying JavaScript functions over HTML elements, friends. And then the JavaScript, so Bootstrap is having both CSS custom, Bootstrap is having predefined CSS styles and predefined JavaScripts also is there. So that's why this is, if you read this one, bootstrap.min.css, that means this is the CSS file in which predefined set of CSS styles will be available. And here you can read bootstrap.min.js. JS means it is a JavaScript file in which all the predefined JavaScript functions will be available. So that is Bootstrap specific. So this is the way of getting the Bootstrap into your web page and linking these predefined styles to your web page. Okay, let me show one example so that you can understand. So here it is, our ready-made document is available, empty document. Now let me define some simple h1 tag. I am taking, friends, simple h1 tag. Okay, I am learning HTML and CSS. Simple h1 tag I am taking, and save. Here it was appeared. Okay, that's right. This is what, there is no styling till now. We didn't define any styles here. Our inline styling is not there, internal styling is also not there. Our external styling sheets are also not provided. This is the default HTML display. Okay, right. So if you want to apply the Bootstrap styles to this element, then you need to specify what. There is no need of style tags. Just take link and then tell rel is equal to style sheet, and then href is equal to, you need to include the what path, it is your decision, your own choice. If you want your bootstrap.css file to exist in your hard drive, then you can download it from getbootstrap.com website and put it in your hard drive, and then you can give that hard drive file path here. And if you don't want that, if you want to use CDN, then you can make use of CDN. But in case of CDN, there is one drawback. If internet doesn't work in your system, then all the CSS styles will not be applicable, because CDN requires internet connection. So if you have internet connection problems, then better use download manually that file and then put it in your hard drive, so that it will be always available to you. So for now I am giving CDN path of the CSS. Okay, CDN. Okay, here I had given. Okay, so entirely it is there now. Okay, now while loading the web page, what the web page does is, as the browser does is, it will go to this address and get all the styles internally, and then it will apply that predefined styles to this h1 element. Okay, let us save it to see the difference. It will take some time. Again in go live. Saving. Whether I'm connecting to internet or not. Okay, connected. So it is not rendering from this particular link. Let me go to that link to verify my internet connection is working or not. Okay, this is the file, friends, Bootstrap 3.4.0. okay, this is the max CDN source code of all the Bootstrap CSS styles. So you can see, you can read it actually, header, footer, right, menu, nav section, display block. So all these are not in particular format. Okay, it is called minified version, right? Minified version. Right, you can make use of, you just copy it, just Control C, Control Copy, and you can put it in your root directory. You can open one file, bootstrap.min.css, like that. Then you copy entire thing here. Okay, what I did is I just go to that website and copied everything. So you can see the horizontal scroll bar. So in one line it has displayed everything. It is not readable, but it computer will understand it. So for humans it is not readable. There is one more source is there, not minified version, it is minified version. If there is not bootstrap.css, it is readable to the developer also. It is good to use. I will show that thing also to you. So now what I did is I directly go to this website where the source of Bootstrap CSS predefined styles are located and copied everything, and I am pasting it in my file, and I put my file in the root directory where server is working. So, and I named it as like this. Now what I will do is, I will, instead of giving this link, I can simply give link like this. Okay, so it is already available in my root folder, that's why. So simple local path I am giving. Okay, so now let us see anything happened. So here it is, our code. Link tag style sheet. Let me define it manually. Link what that rel is equal to style sheet, and then href is equal to what Bootstrap, that's it. Here you can see now it was changed. So earlier in the link it was held up, so that's why I retyped it. Okay, again I inserted it. Okay, so now it came up, so our server hanged up, so now it came up, right? So the Bootstrap is available local directory. So I made use of this file here in the link in the line number 9. I coded like this: link, rel style sheet, and a path I had given. Okay, so that's it, all I did. Okay, but the h1 style I didn't do actually, but the style was changed. You can see if I didn't give this one, let me save it. Here you can see the style now. Okay, this is the default style of HTML. So if you link that bootstrap.min.css, which is predefined style set, then even though you didn't style this h1 element, this document is will target this h1 element and apply the styles which is already predefined in this file. Okay, that is called external CSS. Here you can see now the elements is changing, right? So now I can take paragraph write some code. HTML is great for web. Without the styles, let me save it in order to show you the difference. So this is the default style for H1 and this paragraph. Now if I apply that link, this Bootstrap, then what it will do? So the custom the predefined styles will be loaded to the HTML document from external source. Where is that external source? Here is the external source. Okay, and then in this file, the H1 P element, all elements are styled, okay, predefinedly. Already this P, H1, all these tags are styled, okay, pre-styled and put in this one, and we are not able to read this one. Okay, so I will show the readable format, then you can understand. Then if you save it, then you can see the styles are changing, right? Okay, this is the bottom line of the CSS, friends, and let me show you how the Bootstrap is doing this, how it is targeting, selecting this H1 element and applying these styles. Okay, so where that styles are predefined. So if you want to see that source code, let us move. For that you need .css file, okay, not min.css. min means minified. So let us go to get bootstrap.com. Okay, here it is, the Bootstrap official website, friends. Okay, if you want to download, then it will show. Now at present the version is 4.3. okay, you have two set of files are there, compiled and minified. Minified means the size of the file is somewhat low, and it is easy to easy for the machine to load, okay, speedily, but it is not in readable format, friends, please note. Okay, this is minified, and if you want normal format to read how it is doing, let me download. I am downloading this one to the desktop. Just see, 697 kilobytes of file downloaded. Where it was downloaded. Okay, it is in the web itself, it was downloaded. Okay, now I am taking it in the desktop. Okay, this is the file. Now you will extract it. Let's extract it. It was extracted and I had opened. Let's open this. You can see these two files. Okay, these two files, CSS folder and JS folder. In this folder, this CSS folder consists of only CSS predefined styles, and JS consists of JavaScript predefined functions. Okay, we are discussing CSS, that's why I am not going to the JS, just CSS. You can see these are all the predefined files that are already available. Okay, this is min, and it is minified CSS file, and then this is Bootstrap. Let me open this one, its source code. Okay, here you can see the file name bootstrap.css, not bootstrap.min.css. Okay, bootstrap.min.css will appear like this. Okay, So but bootstrap.css will appear in a proper format. Okay, so this is the root. So here they are defining some colors. Okay, so and for HTML, for HTML tag, they are declaring the font family as sans serif, line height, all those things. Okay, here you can see they are selecting the footer, header, main, nav section, and make it as display block. So they are already designed all these things. What is CSS? Selecting an element and applying properties, right? So here the Bootstrap people are already did that work for us. Here you can see, so they selected the body and then applied these properties, margin, font family, font size, everything. And we no need to again define the body. Okay, so if you want custom styles, then you can define. If you don't want, then these styles alone is enough. Now for our discussion, what is our discussion? How these styles are applied to this, okay, H1 and P1. Okay, now we need to go to this H1 tag in the bootstrap.css. Here you can see 76th line. 76th line, the Bootstrap people already styled, declared all these properties for the tags, H1 tag, H2, H3, up to H6. They are defining as margin top 0, margin bottom, this one. Okay, and paragraph tag, they are applying these two. Okay, and the font family, they already declared as body. So where our H1 tag is included in the body itself. So that's why the font family is this one. Okay, font family, they have defined here. No, so many families are defined and sans serif. So what are all the if you don't have the font specified here, some default fonts will be applicable to you. Okay, the bottom line is here, you can see and understand it. These are all not developed by us, not declared by us, but Bootstrap is having all these things inbuiltly, predefinedly. Just we are making use of these ones. Okay, here OL, UL, DL, all are selected and applied these properties to them. If we use it, okay, let me tell you that thing also. OL, take it, list, take it, some HTML, and then CSS, and then Java script. Okay, so I am not defining any styles, you please observe. Okay, so no inline styling is done by me, or internal styling is done by me. I just included the Bootstrap file. This is method is called external CSS, and in the external CSS also I am not defining anything. This bootstrap.min.css is already having those styles. Let me save. Here you can see, okay, without these, let me remove this line and save. Okay, this is the font, this is the font, this is the font. Fonts are changed. No, let me insert this one and save. Now you can see the difference, right? The fonts are changing, formats are changing, right? So this is the theory and practice regarding the Bootstrap, friends. So to discuss more about Bootstrap, it requires so much time and effort and practice, friends. Okay, but it's worth Okay, so if you need to learn this Bootstrap, let me show this file. Okay, so all these are predefined. You can see all these things. So yeah, that means anchor tags, anchor hover, when you hover which color will appear. Okay, so all these things, prefigure, SVG, table baller collapse, we learned these things in our table classes, HTML table classes and styling classes, but it is already predefined TH, how it will align, right? All those things are predefined. You can see 347 is known. Let us go to the end of the Bootstrap. Some, how many lines? 10,000 lines. You can see the 10,000 lines of CSS source code is already predefined by Bootstrap people for us. Okay, just we can make use of these already predefined CSS styles. That's it. For that, all we have to do is remember these class names. Table dark, if you apply this table dark class in your HTML source code, like if you give this class in the class some predefined class, if you give here this class, this time you can you will give Bootstrap class, okay, not your class, Bootstrap classes, like here it is a container. No, if you give this one, it will be automatically applied. Let me give to the test one. So container, put it in a container. If you do it, okay, now see the change here, it is automatically indents are decreasing. Okay, because you applied the class, which class? Container class. So eventually this container class will be targeted by the Bootstrap. Why means here the container class is already defined. Wherever you use this container, this will be applied, right? And navbar also, like that. This is the table. If you use the table class as table, then it will be, this function will be applied, this declaration, these properties will be applied. Okay friends, that is the concept of Bootstrap. Okay, so for fast and easier development, Bootstrap is the way, friends. Okay, so with this Bootstrap, the topic of Bootstrap, just I am introduced the Bootstrap, what is Bootstrap, why to use Bootstrap and how to use Bootstrap, that's it. So Bootstrap, for learning Bootstrap completely, it will require so much of time. Okay, time, but it is very easy. You can do it, but the learning path is first learn HTML, then CSS, then Bootstrap. Okay, then Bootstrap. Okay, for fast and easier development of CSS, learn Bootstrap, and then JavaScript you need to learn. Okay, so this is the path, friends. So with this, I'm ending this class, and in the next class we will do some other topics, friends. Till then, bye bye. Your Svira signing off. Thank you for listening.